Welcome to the EasyGovOps File Cabinet Pipeline Management Platform. What I wanted to show you is basically how to take any item within EasyGovOps platform that will have a little suitcase icon next to that particular item. I'm actually in the dashboard right now. If you're in any search module, be it solicitations or subcontracts, company modules, be it whatever, you can place anything within your file cabinet and they all will have this little icon on the particular respective summary page. So if I wanted to take this particular item, simply click on the blue link. Everything in our tool that is a blue is either hyperlinked or clickable, to actually be able to do some other actions. In this particular case, let's say if I wanted to take this Transformation 21 Total Technology Next Generation solicitation and put it within my file cabinet as a file cabinet save, very simply press the suitcase button. At this particular juncture, I can actually place this in any file folder that perhaps I created and or my team. Now remember, the EasyGovOps platform is a very team-oriented platform as well, or at least provides that availability. If you wanted to put it in a brand new folder, we call them categories. So very simply, I'll just call this test 1, 2, 3. And we'll give it a description. I'll just put test in there just for demo purposes. I'll give it a high priority in this particular case. So I'll add this physically to the file cabinet. Two things happen. One, it leaves you right back to where you were initially. And you'll notice on this particular summary page, and this will be prevalent on anything that you want to save within your file cabinet, this box will automatically appear as your last screen image, just basically verifying that you placed that particular summary page, be it whatever it is, in your actual file cabinet. And it gives you, if it's a solicitation and or a contract, or what we call recompete or pre-forecast RFP, this box will actually be present to allow you to actually put in your pipeline. So that's a whole other additive as well. So if I wanted to add this item, let's go ahead and do this now, in my pipeline as well. Again, you can open up this particular item in your file cabinet and later as another activity added to your pipeline. But let's say if I want to give a unique value, let's say $30,000, and let's give it a high value of $40,000. We ask for both entries just because of the fact it'll cover the full gamut as a low range and a high value range. And we allow you to actually select a probability notation about this particular opportunity. Now, if you want to save this physically in your pipeline, you must press save to actually save that entry. And keep in mind, any item that you want to save in your file cabinet, you are allowed to actually make notes. Any summary page that you save within your archives, again, within the file cabinet, I can basically save any note whatsoever. My team can collectively make notes thereafter. Again, this just builds up kind of as a litany of comments for your entire team. So let's basically reemphasize what we had just done as an action. We took the Transformation 21 solicitation. We've actually identified that we want to put this in the actual file cabinet. I've actually done a combination effort, put it in my pipeline, by an action of adding that as a low value, 30,000, high value, 40,000, probability of win, 75%, and also make comments as well. Now, at this particular juncture, if I want to go to my file cabinet, the Quick Links module, which is this left module, basically allows me access to actually physically click on the My File Cabinet pipeline management tool. So I want to leave this particular page. And in doing so, what will happen is it'll bring you kind of to a montage listing page of everything that you have listed within your file cabinet. You have a toolbar. You just simply hover over this. It will explain exactly in detail all the little icons within this top toolbar header. So again, you have the availability to categorize things, sort things, all the kinds of unique adventures within this particular platform. Now, we have a myriad of different things with this platform that actually make it ease of use, sense of archiving. Any item that you save, if it's a solicitation, it will have an icon for a solicitation. If it's a physical contract that you save, it'll have an icon for a contract. Again, you can save people, subcontracts, awards, be it whatever. The icon will be representative of that particular save. If you want to sort by those particular icons, again, you can sort by all the contracts that you have in your file cabinet. Quite simply, just press on the contract icon, and in doing so, it will actually sort and bring up all the contracts, which will be at the top of your list. Now, keep in mind, this particular file cabinet, I have, for example, hundreds and hundreds of items. I just brought just the contracts to the forefront. But if I wanted to deselect this, bring up everything, and you can do two different ways. You can clear this. You can sort. Because you didn't sort anything, it'll actually ask you to sort. But quite simply, if you press clear search, It'll revert everything back to its original state. In this particular juncture, I'll clear the search, and you'll notice I have hundreds of items saved in the file cabinet, many, 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 many items. Again, all sorts of different items that I physically have saved. So we allow you to sort. We've already identified that as such. If you want to sort by items that you put in your pipeline, you can actually assign an icon. This particular item, as you know, we just put that in our pipeline moments ago. We did a combination double effort, put it in the file cabinet and as well in the pipeline. And you'll notice any entry in your pipeline, which is your pipeline chart over here to the right, any new entry at the 3 o'clock position will always be the location of new entries within your pipeline chart. You know, so you don't have to kind of hunt as to what new entry you just entered. Again, all these little three-dimensional pie slices. Now you'll notice by just hovering over that pie slice, you'll actually see a percentage of that particular opportunity of the 100% pie. The 100%, you know, pie figure would be the red number at the you know, above the location of the actual pie chart. In this particular case, 1.6 million. Well, this particular opportunity is 1.86% of the 100% pie. It's a $30,000 value. We're currently looking at a low value in a sense of all the opportunities in your pipeline. You can simply change the chart and reflect a high value by toggling to the max value radio button switch. So here's how you actually, if you would like to, print out anything for your management team so you know everything that's in your respective pipeline. Again, the file cabinet slash pipeline management platform is designed for individual use, and or you can share your file cabinet within your entire team. It doesn't matter if you have 1,000 people part of your team. I'm going to show you how to do that in a few moments. But if you want to actually print out a print-ready chart of the pipeline chart, and even the chart itself is three-dimensional. So let's say if you have a five-person team, Susie's responsible for all the BD efforts of you know, doing the intel in numbers 2, number 4, number, you know, 6 slice or 5 slice, you know, whatever, it doesn't matter. She can do a print-ready chart of this, show the management team that she's personally responsible for the BD efforts on those opportunities. So if you scroll down to the bottom, the last entry that we just entered, ironically, is number 17, is that transformation 21 total. Again, this is a high value because that's the last action I did, is a high value chart. And this one happens to be 2.77% of the 100% pie. Again, there's a print icon, top right-hand corner. That is, you know, again, going to make the management team very happy about having that intel for them. Again, anything you add to your pipeline will be reflective as an automatic update within that pipeline chart. So you'll have a bunch of other different avenues as well as what specifically what the file cabinet does. You'll notice the red flag actually in the toolbar. The red flag, and it actually is identified as well here, so it just has, you know, is a memory retention kind of method. The red flag quite simply means modifications. When you see these white flags as all the line item items, if a solicitation and or contract and or an award get modified, those are the three, you know, three things that actually get modified on a regular, you know, occurrence. When in fact you save those items in your file cabinet, it's automatically a trigger alert to our 80 million records coming into our tool on a daily occasion to alert you and or your team. Again, you can share your file cabinet. If you share it, your team will get the very same email, just in case you're on vacation or what have you, about that particular item being modified. That white flag will turn to red. You very simply click on the blue link to actually view that. Once you view the mod as to whatever mod activity it was, it will, first of all, the line item itself will automatically be updated to the mod as well. The summary page will reflect the latest mod. We very simply did the combination effort where your entire team would actually get the email again because it's set up with a kind of a team framework. The email notification for you about the mod will happen at the very same time frame, 7 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, the following morning, each morning. So if a mod happens today, tomorrow morning, 7 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, you will get an email with a hyperlink to actually drive you to that particular file cabinet saved item. So that's basically kind of an overview of the file cabinet in kind of its basic form. Now there's a lot of other additives here that are available to you as a user. You know, obviously we talked about the pipeline management tool. You can take any of these items and actually move them from one file folder to another. You noticed that a couple minutes ago, I created the test 123 category or file folder name. If I wanted to move that file folder to another file folder, very simply, I press the edit button, and in doing so, The other available folders that either I created or my team has created allows me the flexibility to be able to put those items into other specific categories or file folders. In this particular case, I'm going to move it from test 123 to Mike's file folder, which he might be a sub user of yours, or basically it might be a priority level file folder name. Right? You can create these dynamic file folders any way that you would like. When you update this to the file cabinet, what will happen is that particular item will now physically have been moved, as you can see on the first line item, from test 123 to Mike's folder. If you would like to see the contents of all the folders or any chosen folder, very simply over to the right, blue hyperlinks, you can click on the particular title of that particular folder to see all the contents of that folder. You can delete, you can rename, you can add subcategories. Very simply, the plus icon allows you the ability to be able to create subcategories. Any file folder to the right that has a plus icon next to it will literally visually show you that there are subfolders already created for that particular file folder. Again, everything is listed within the tool tips. If you ever forget anything within any of the modules, the tips button in that respective module will give you a grand overture of how to utilize that particular module. We also have a play video button as well. Now, we do a sharing mechanism. We allow you to actually share your file cabinet. And when you share your file cabinet, you're actually sharing your pipeline management platform as well. It's not a either-or proposition. It's either you share or you don't share. How this works is an example. Let's say if you have a gold plan, you have up to 5 users. If you share your file cabinet, all 5 members will actually have access to the shared file cabinet. All 5 members will have access to your shared proposal management platform. The smallest button on this particular screenshot, ironically, is probably the most powerful, which is this Share Team File Cabinet icon, the plus icon. Whoever has admin control, either the owner of EasyGovOps or the owner has added subusers and given them admin control, and you can do that under the User tab to identify the status or level of participation of your subusers. Whoever has ownership or admin control can see the plus button. Regular users cannot even see the plus button under the same shared your membership. Whoever has the ability or whoever has the power or permission is probably the best way to describe it as to choosing their file cabinet as the file cabinet of choice for the entire team. Again, a massive communication effort between yourself and your team as to who is that specific chosen one. Whenever they press the plus button, in doing so, it will create a message what you are about to do as a new action. You'll have a toggle switch. It'll be automatically by default be turned off. If you turn that toggle switch on, so a case point example, Mark is the team owner, Susie is the sub-user, but Susie's admin control. Mark has said, Susie, you have the power. You make your file cabinet of choice for the entire team. Susie basically would turn this toggle switch on, and in doing so, the entire file cabinet will now be shared between herself and the entire team, and everybody on the team can actually see Susie's file cabinet. They can put stuff in her file folders. Susie creates new file folders. They can obviously interact in that respect. They can create their own file folders, obviously, on Susie's platform. Again, everybody's interacting with one universal file cabinet presence. So the last aspect of the actual file cabinet I want to do a quick overture is that you can search for anything as a keyword that is in any category or description or comments or what we call SPO type, which is just simply the summary page overview or whatever you put in your actual file cabinet. It will actually find whatever keyword that you type. In this particular case, I made notes about varied amounts of saved items. If I press submit, it will actually find all the items that have that particular name in it. Again, if you know a partial name of an opportunity or what have you, or if it's a company intel, summary page that you saved, very simply you can type that and we'll bring back all the results. It's going to be in either the opportunity title or the actual category title, description, or comments. It'll find it wherever it is. Again, press clear. It'll divert it back to the original state of the file cabinet. Now, keep in mind, one other notation is whenever there are modifications, we know that people do not scroll down. We do not want to have force or members to scroll down to see the latest mods that they might be line item number 78. By automatic code conditions, the EasyGovOps knows that people are not quite frankly going to scroll down. We move it to the top of the list. So if number 78 gets modified within your file cabinet, it will physically move to the top of the list. A red flag will be identified next to it. You're going to get your email. You click the blue hyperlink. The item will automatically be updated. And you tell the system, just by the action, that I appreciate, you know, the obviously the modification update. We put a quick view. If you hover over any item within your file cabinet, it'll present a quick view. If you hover over for 2 seconds, the entire tool is built for speed. We also put a mechanism in here. We have many, many clients that, you know, basically searched, you know, for state, local. They obviously are, you know, involved with commercial opportunities as well. The way this platform is designed, we have a button placed within this file cabinet. It's a blank template. Simply click it. Upon that action of clicking it, you can actually put a state, local, or commercial opportunity in your shared file cabinet or in your individualized file cabinet in your pipeline management platform. You put the title, put whatever you can import, you know, cut, paste, a Word document in here, whatever you want to do. Very simply, put a generic template in place to cover most of the field points for those commercial, state, or local opportunities that are common field points. But again, you can add new dynamic field points down here and add new fields. There's no limit to add new field points. But quite simply, the power of what this tool will provide for you and your team, you can add that particular commercial, state, or local opportunity to your pipeline. The same essence as what I showed moments ago. But more importantly, you can add that particular commercial, state, and local opportunity to your SharePoint-like value that's built within the team framework of this. Again, you can, you know, choose admin or user status for your subusers. Again, now you will be assigned a particular workspace. You can assign tasks, you upload files, you know, internal emails back and forth between yourself and your team with a commercial, state, and local opportunity with a file cabinet saving combination. Extremely powerful for users as well. Now, that is a great overview of the file cabinet. As you can well imagine, this is extremely complex, portion of the actual platform, and we welcome you to take advantage of it. There's all kinds of other avenues. You can export, you can delete en masse. Very simply to export, you can select if I will do 1, 3, and 5 line items I want to export as an Excel file, simply highlight them, press export to CSV, which is automatically an Excel file. Yeah, Excel file, you'll be able to utilize that and create pivot tables or whatever you would like to do. If you would like to highlight all of them, you know, to export, simply press the toolbar to be able to do that. So thank you very much for your attention to details on this file cabinet, and we want you to take advantage of the EasyGovOps platform. Thank you.